Hey guys, and welcome back to some more Final Fantasy 16. I'm actually going to go back down this way for just a minute because it's been obviously a very long time since I've played this game, but today I just turned it on and I have seen that there is an update that allows you to change Clive's appearance. His appearance as well as the party. So I just want to actually check that out. Here it is. Okay, so appearance. All right, so appearances matter. Use the appearance option, the redstone. I'm not sure how to say that really. To change the outward appearance of Clive or his party members, the appearance of Clive's weapon can also be changed. Okay, to that of any previously obtained. I actually really like that. Okay, so we can have Clive. I actually really like Clive's current look, but that's actually pretty cool too. The burnt black. I'm gonna try this one on for a while. Let's see what Jill can wear. Ooh, Snow White. I like Torgal. You can get him icy blue or normal. All right, well, we'll go with this just because it's different. And then the same with Ambrosia. We can get in this Rosarian gold. So let's do that. And then with the weapon. Okay, so there was a weapon that I really liked that we obtained. I think it was this one, was it? Let me just have a look. There's actually a lot of very nice ones. Oh, maybe it was this one. Just a plain kind of Invictus one. Oh my god, there's actually some really, really nice looking weapons. I'm trying to remember which weapon it was that I liked. More so in even how it fitted in his sheath on the back. So, okay. I feel like it might have been this one. I'm going to go for this. And that's the one that's actually in the image there. So maybe that is the one. The one that we got when we got this gear. And that is a smashing. Oh my god, look at the red. Oh, that is amazing. That looks so cool. Okay, I'm really happy right now. Okay, so I'm actually going to move on with the story.
Editors started reading books that don't have any pictures in.
Okay, so we're just heading down now to Mid, and we are reporting back to her after doing a load of little quests for her in the last one. Was it three of them we done?
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mid, but you'll be pleased to know that work on the shielding is underway.
You found something for it?
In a manner of speaking, Harpocrates knew of a substance that's highly resistant to heat, a coating that should provide the protection you need. He's supervising the construction and testing of the shielding as we speak.
Brilliant! I knew you wouldn't let me down.
Don't thank me. I'm just the errand boy.
Right then. Better start working out how to bolt all these bits together. To the Black Hammer!
You know, when I got into the smithing game, I thought I'd be making swords and shields, not thermal bleeding didgeridoo-dahs.
Displacement stacks.
Same difference. Whatever you call it, I ain't putting it together in here. It's cramped enough as it is. Let's take this outside. Mid, you get all the parts lined up on the deck. I'll take care of the rest.
On my way!
Oh, and bring me the biggest ammo you can find. This is gonna require some precision walloping.
It's finished! It's finally finished!
Thank fuck for that. I'll be feeling my hammer arm for weeks.
Thank you, Clive, Blackthorn, everyone. That's one down and just three more to go.
I'm sorry.
Oh, didn't I tell you? The Enterprise has four Mithril engines, and we'll be needing a displacement stack for each.
You don't mean...
Don't worry. Now they've got a finished one to work off, my gang in Canva can build the rest.
Good luck to them, I say. Right, I'm off to get a sling for this elbow. Any other work comes in, keep it to yourselves, eh?
What's the matter?
Nothing. Just daydreaming. Thinking about the Enterprise sailing off over the horizon to shores unknown. Searching for a land untouched by the Blight. Just like me and my dad planned. So if the worst came to the worst and every scrap of soil in the Twins turned black, we might still have a chance. That's what she was meant to be. You see, one last chance just in case we needed it. But now she's so close to being finished, I've realised I don't want her to be that. I don't want her to be just a lifeboat for us to cling to if things get desperate. I want people to sail aboard her by choice, not from the lack of it. In a world where we're not just trying to survive, but where we can actually live.
I'm working on that. And I'll do everything I can to get you what you want.
Don't you always? All right. My mind's made up. As soon as the Enterprise is fit to sail, I'm putting her under your command. Sod our plans. I'm trusting in yours.
Are you sure about this?
Something tells me it's what my dad would have wanted.
He'd be proud of you.
You were gonna visit his grave, weren't you?
I was. And you can come too, now that your little project is finished.
Right. There's just one thing I need to finish up first. Won't be a mo.
All right. I'll let Otto know you're coming. Meet us in the mess when you're ready.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Okay, so there has been obviously a while since I last recorded this. I was out of the country for a while, so didn't have any opportunities to record or even edit. Alright, Otto.
Alright, Clive. Astrix. We'd finished sending half the hideaway traipsing across the Twins, has she? I swear, that girl'd do anything to put off visiting her old dad's grave. No excuses now, though, eh?
Not quite. She said there was one final thing she had to take care of. I'm sure she'll be finished soon enough.
She said that? In those words?
She did, yes.
Clive? Were you born yesterday or something? There is no thing. She'll probably be halfway to Canva by now.
Oh, man. I might still be able to catch her.
I swear to God, this fucking child.
Is that the thing Toes helped with?
Obelith, have you seen Mid?
Yep. In a boat, going that way.
Then I'm too late.
You in a hurry and all, are ya? I offered to take her across, but she wouldn't wait. Just paid for a dinghy and rowed off. Oars going like the clappers. Got some life in her, ain't she? But anyway, I was on my way up to see you, as it happens. Got a letter for you. Urgent, by the sound of it. One of your uncle's men said I was to hand it to you in person, post-bleeding haste. And you're here now.
Thank you, Obelith.
Don't mention it.
What tidings, Uncle?
Okay, so guys, we have a letter here. I'm going to leave you read through it. And I am basically going to cut out what I read of it.
Trouble in Canver. Well, I'll need someone to keep an eye on Mid.
So what? Mid got us to do all the dirty work and then just sailed off into the sunset?
It, seems that way.
Well, nothing we can do about it now. But next time you plan on visiting Cid, you might want to tie her to something before you suggest it.
Ah, don't be so hard on her. Gotta admit, the dirty work was kind of fun. Everyone pitching in, all that bollocks. Just like when we built this place.
You're right.
Anyway, we all set to head to the old hideaway. I could do with getting to Canva pretty sharpish. Wouldn't do to keep Lord Rosfield of the Seven High Houses waiting now, would it? Not after he asked for me personally.
Gav will be leaving with me. Will you mind the place while we're gone?
You can count on me. Just be sure to give Sid and the others my regards. All right.
Oh, by the way, Jill will be joining us too. She's got some things to take care of, but she'll meet us there.
I hope she's telling the truth at least. Sid, I remember what you told me. But if no one is listening to what you have to say, you may as well not say it. But I will say this, old friend. Hugo Cooker is gone. His shadow looms over us no longer.
It's a pity the Phoenix can't be in two places at once. If he'd have been with us, maybe he could have done something for the Lost.
Not even the Phoenix can bring people back from the dead. Life has a beginning and an end. So we must live while we have the chance. As slaves to the crystals, but as free men.
May we join you?
Lady Karen, what a pleasant surprise.
I thought I'd drop by and see how you were all doing before heading off to restock my supplies.
Wasn't the most scenic view back then, but it were never as bad as this.
I know. The Blight marches on. And soon, there'll be no escaping sights like these.
So our mission remains unchanged. We cannot stop until every Mother Crystal is gone, and their thirst for ether with them. The only one that remains in Storm is Drake's Tail in the Crystalline Dominion.
Our next target.
We're going to Twinside.
It's the capital of the Empire these days. I wouldn't like to think how tightly guarded they've got the place. Not that that'll stop you, but we do well to scout it out before you go charging in.
We would indeed.
If you're off to the Dominion, you can take this great lump with you.
Goots.
Oh, I am sorry. Have you forgotten you're the most wanted man in the Twins? I thought you might like to disguise yourselves as the attendants of a travelling trader, assuming you've no better ideas. You wanted to buy yourself some tools, didn't you? Well, now's your chance.
You're letting me go with them? Oh, thanks, man!
Stop that! You break me bones, you great galoot! There's a caravan that runs back and forth between the Dominion and the Boklad markets. It's managed by the Merchants Guild. Just show them Goots' traders pass and you'll be on your way. It'll be a damn sight less risky than footing it the length of the Crystal Road. That's for sure.
Thank you, Karen. And glad to have you with us, Goots.
Okay then. I'll get me things and I'll meet yous there. See yous down in Boklad!
Get off! Me poor fingers!
Jill, you're with me.
Understood.
And Gav?
Already on my way, Captain.
Be careful.
Aren't I always?
Do you see that, Sid? Your protege's making a proper little outlaw of himself.
Okay, onward. All right, so just for anyone.
Better. Thanks to Taya.
I'm glad to hear it.
And Torgal helped too. The new boy.
Right. For anyone that was wondering about the letter that didn't really want to bother reading it, it's basically just that people may or may not know about them using the docks. And it was...
This used to be a trade route for merchants crossing the Scars. Till the Republic laid a new road wide enough to let wagons pass. And all official traffic moved there.
Leaving this one for those living outside the law.
Indeed. I doubt we'll be the only outlaws on the trail today.
Okay, so yeah, they wanted to know basically if they could use Gav. In order to figure out if he knows anything or if he hears or sees anything about people that may want to cause harm to them and their cause. So that's basically all it was. Is that hellfire a different color to what it normally is? I'm not really sure. Alright, so it's been a while since I played this, so I don't really remember a whole lot here. But I do know this bit. Right, and I think, yeah, that's the dodge. Right, okay. Right, we can switch. No, we can switch with this, and we can use those. Okay, so, kind of getting the hang of this.
allies.
Oh.
They have a hideaway of their own.
Alright, well, let's... Oh man, I keep forgetting that. Okay, wait a minute. No, 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 that's not what I wanted to do at all. Okay. Oh, staggered, beautiful. Oh my god, this is going on a while. Oh man, okay. Oh man, I'm doing the same thing. Okay. Alright, they're all used up, so we nearly have them anyway. Oh shit, man. Let's use a potion. Right. This is not really needed, but there we go. I should actually really check to see if I have any ability points I can use.
We've done the Republic a service.
Oh no, that's not it. I was actually going to press triangle there for a second. When was the last time I needed to press triangle in a Final Fantasy game? Okay, so we have a fair few points. Question is, what can we use them on? So we could use it on that. We could get those things again. I keep like getting rid of those kinds of things. Right, that's actually useful. So the taunt one is not, but how much does it give me? 40 points. I only need like 10 or something, do I? Let me just see. Oh yes. Go with it. There we go. Actually, did I grab the item that was over there when I came in? I must have. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, damn. I thought that was a chest. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the way Torgal looks right now. All the other guys, I think, look amazing.
I see the Dalmex lag behind Rosaria when it comes to bridge building.
The fallen ruin should hold, at least. The path continues on the other side.
Why do I feel like something's going to happen when you say stuff like that? Oh, here we go.
Stay down.
Oh man, you hit me. No, no. Oh, level up, lovely. Alright, wait a minute. Oh no, it doesn't tell me how many KP points I get from that. I don't have that many though. Okay. 69 in total, is it? Okay.
The gods. It's even more impressive than I imagined. I remember being captivated by the story as a child.
Long, long ago, man was overcome by avarice and challenged the gods in a bid to win their power. A final battle took place here, at these falls. Or so the legend goes. If anyone ever manages to plumb those depths, perhaps we'll learn if there's any truth to the tale.
That the gods emerged victorious and punished man for his defiance by visiting upon him two curses.
Dominance in bearers. To tell the truth, I always thought it strange that the dominant and their icons were deemed a curse. Back home, the dominant inherited the throne. They were admired and exalted, not spurned. Whenever I got to that part of the story, I always assumed there must be something I'd misunderstood.
You had a lot of storybooks, didn't you? In your room, I mean. When we were young.
The old legends were always my favorites. Epic battles between gods and men. Father encouraged me to read as much as I could. He thought it good for my education.
You really were a boy like any other, weren't you?
Just look at this place. It's enough to make you believe the legends are true.
I know.
We're not far from Boklad. The road will be busier up ahead.
Then we'll have to keep our wits about us. Clive? Something wrong?
Nothing. It's nothing.
See, the reports are true, Father. You have surrendered the throne to Olivier.
I have. Emperor Olivier shall rebuild the Holy Empire of Sambrek.
How is he to rule an empire? He is but a boy.
I shall advise him until he comes of age.
Father, please.
Or for as long as I am able. The empire we seek to build needs young blood to rule it. And I can think of none better suited to the task. There is other news, Dion. Hugo Kupka is dead, and Drake's Fang destroyed. The pillars of the Republic have fallen. Ere long, the Imperial banner shall fly over every city in storm. And then, Valisthea. All shall bow before their Emperor.
Father, these are the words of a tyrant.
They are the words of a god. The emperor whom I gladly serve. Great Grieger, made flesh. Return to your camp, Dion, and ready your forces. It is time to show the world the true power of Sambrek.
Father. I find you much changed. Is this truly the path you wish to tread? Or are these the ambitions of another? Of Ultima, perhaps?
What nonsense is this? I speak my mind, and my mind only. Though I do owe Annabella thanks for reminding me of certain truths. Regarding the nature of nations, of rulers, and of the divine.
You trust the words of this traitress? She betrayed her country! She slew her husband!
You have ever been an invaluable servant to Sambrek, Prince Dion. I trust you will continue to serve your emperor in the wars to come.
The canker!
Silence! Insolent wretch! You will bend the knee. All else is heresy.
Sire, forgive me.
This audience is over. Come, your radiance. The Rowena Syndicate awaits your pleasure.
Oh, not another meeting with silly old men. They're so boring. I'm hungry, Father. Can't we have luncheon instead?
Does it pain you that you will not inherit your father's throne?
I have suffered worse.
Count your blessings, Dion. For a base-born child to be chosen by Bahamut is miracle enough. You have risen high on his wings, but you shall rise no higher, lest your impure blood stain the throne.
What do you know of my blood?
Clab markets are to the north. We just need to hug the coast.
Okay, so guys, this is actually a... Oh, shit! Okay. Sorry, this is not a shit. This is a good place to end this episode, so thanks for watching, guys. Please like the video if you liked it. Feel free to leave a comment. And as always, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more. And I just remembered I have a chocobo. Which is not that. It's this. Alright.
Ready, girl?